eager bride. Oh, I don't have brides arriving at this time. Heather, I don't have brides arriving. I can give presents. Just make sure that the groom is.
Sensible tableaus in the jewel already.
No, I never would have asked. That's it. Pete, just stay there. That's it. Come and stand. Yeah, that's it.
That's it,
no, no, stay holding your daughter's hand. That's it, lovely, and stay with her. Thanks.
Yes.
Yes.
That's good. So, ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. It has long been a tradition for family members to escort a bride to her wedding ceremony. Today, Pete, as Heather's dad, and Vince, her brother, have had the honour of walking her down the aisle. And now I ask you both, are you, Vince and Pete, happy for Heather to marry Steve, and do you wish them well on their journey together?
Yes.
So yes.
Smile.
That's what
we're
doing. Sister kiss.
No.
Yes. So good afternoon. And welcome on this July afternoon to Botticut House, where we're here to celebrate the marriage of Steve and Heather. It is in the spirit of sincerity as well as joy that Steve and Heather understand and undertake the ultimate commitment of marriage. They wish to pledge and honour this simple yet binding commitment from this day forward. And they both understand the responsibilities as well as the enjoyment of this serious commitment to each other. And through your presence here, you're expressing your support for them both, not just for today, but in the future too. And we hope that today will be truly happy and memorable for you both and for everyone who shares it with you. Steve, Stephen John Carruthers and Heather Jane Woodward have come here today to be married and have invited you all to witness this occasion and to share with them in their happiness. However, if any person present makes a if any person present knows of any lawful impediment why these two people may not be joined in marriage, they should declare it to us now. It's okay, is it?
He's smiling.
Chris, may I continue? Thank you. Chris is the registrar today, and he's responsible for all the legal aspects of the ceremony. And himself and I are delighted to be able to share with you today in this very special celebration. Special. As he not only proudly discussed his motorbike with her, he showed her the black gaffer taped up side of it. And apparently that was very important. They both decided whilst chatting at home that perhaps they had reached a stage in their relationship where they should change their mind about marriage. And they could, they should, and they would get married to each other. And so we're here today. The marriage ceremony allows a couple to formally make this lifelong commitment to their partner. Today, Steve and Heather confirm before you their wish to join their lives and their futures, sharing their strengths and their worries, their wishes and their goals, giving love, support and encouragement to each other in everything they do. Marriage joins two people who trust the love they have found. It's a partnership in which each can grow. A happy marriage is about never forgetting the importance of compromise and accepting each other for who they are. And a good partner will be loving, caring, but above all, a very best friend. Now, your mum, Jean, is going to come forward because she has some
here at such a happy occasion. My eldest son is reclining in Spain, and he has been known to go to a wedding, pretend he's lost the speech, and bring out a 2-inch piece of paper for it. But look what we've got here.
These are the hands of your best friend. Safe and strong and full of love for you, that are looking and holding yours on your wedding day. As you promise to love each other today, tomorrow and forever, these are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you plan your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times, wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will embrace your families as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and old, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch.
Okay. Thank you.
So now the solemn moment has come for Steve and Heather to contract their marriage before you all. So I could invite you all to stand and join together in the celebration. In the presence of your families and friends, Steve and Heather, will you both share the difficult times as well as the happy times?
Sometimes.
And will you both promise to love and care for one another, whatever the future may bring? I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present.
Here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Stephen.
Stephen.
Do take thee, Heather.
Do take thee, Heather.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
And Heather, please say to Steve, I call upon these persons.
I call upon these persons.
Here present.
Here present.
To witness that I, Heather. To witness that I, Heather. Do take thee, Stephen.
To take thee, Stephen.
To be my lawful wedded husband. Now, Carl has the wedding ring. You have chosen to follow the tradition spanning over 2,000 years of sealing your marriage with the exchange of rings. These wedding rings symbolise the everlasting nature of your love by representing unbroken circles with neither beginning nor end. They act as the outward sign of the lifelong promises that you make to each other today. So before we exchange rings, we're just going to ask everybody else to sit down. So if everybody would like to be seated. So would you like to pass that to Steve for me, please?
I think it goes to sweetest, loveliest parents. Unless you've got your own mouth.
I love romance.
So I give you this ring to show you my love for you and that the love will last forever and for the rest of my life. You've made my life complete. I love you.
Oh, that's just beautiful. Thank you. And now I should pass the other ring to Heather Cole. Thank you very much. Would you like to place it on Steve's finger, Heather?
Yep.
And I know you have some words that you've written that you would like to say to Steve.
I give you this ring as I've given you my heart, honestly, completely and forever. Wear it and think of me and know how I'll always love you and always be there for you. It's taken until now for me to discover what the phrase my other half really means. You really are the other half of me that's been missing all my adult life. When we met, it was like finding a matching jigsaw piece. We just fitted so perfectly together. We match in so many ways. Children, grandchildren, likes, passions, bikes, music, food. We even have matching helmet sizes. Life is a journey, and in one way or another has caused both of us a few bumps and bruises and metal pins. But it's the future that's out there now, and it's ours to discover and enjoy together. Since we met, my life has changed so much and I've learned so much. We've rarely been apart and both hate it when we are. And this is just the beginning. I'm so excited about spending the rest of our lives together and enjoying our new experiences that are yet to come. With our can-do attitude and everything we do, with you by my side, nothing is unachievable. I found my very own Peter Pan, my bionic man, and my absolute soulmate. No one knows what's around the corner, but I'm looking forward to getting round those apexes together and running against the wind with you.
So you have now both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of everybody here today. This day is the start of a new life for you together, and we hope the feelings of love you have now will grow ever stronger as the years to come. And it is my privilege and my honour to introduce you to everybody as husband and wife. Would you now like to give a united kiss? Congratulations. So if you'd like to both be seated, I'm going to hand over to Chris and he's going to write a little bit of a
picture.
So ladies and gentlemen, to conclude the ceremony, we have one very important duty. And Chris,
Steve, Heather, congratulations to you both. So by tradition, we normally present a certificate to the person best able to look after it for now and into the future. Well, Steve, definitely can't be you. But, thank you, congratulations.
Thank you.
Heather, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Well
done. For others.
What a love. What a man.
Hi.
don't like you.
And it's the first time that her and Steve were like together apart. And it was so in public, apparently. But seeing them there, you would never have known that they'd really not known each other that long. And already you can see they're absolutely amazing couple. So when Heather obviously said to me, as she did to many of you, that she was thinking of, well, they were looking at sort of tying the knot, I couldn't have been any more than happier, because I know, obviously, you know, as you said, we've all had ups and downs in our lives and things like that. And although there's been some lovely things, we've got beautiful granddaughters there, beautiful daughters, you know, you deserved a bit of happiness, and it was so, so lovely to do that. And actually, to be invited to the wedding was a really, really great honour as well. So all I'd love to do is just, I think, for us all to raise our glasses to a fantastic couple. I've met Steve on quite a few occasions. I'm looking forward to meeting them even more. They are living life to the full, and they're going to live life even more, as they should do as well. And everybody deserves happiness, and I think it's absolutely amazing that you found it now. And I know you'll make the most of it. And thank you so, so much for allowing us and for everybody else to be such a part of such a special day. So don't ever forget how special you are. Everyone, go out there, just grab life by the horns.
Get your hand off his bum.
And thank you so much for what has been so far such an amazing... I'm a little bit in the bridal industry, so I meet a lot of brides all the time, and I can see all the time and effort that goes in certain weddings. But this has been so lovely because it's been so personal, it's been so you. You put so much of both of you in it, and I think that's made it even more special. So I think we all should raise our glasses to Kevin and Steve for a fantastic, and the families coming together as well, for a fantastic.